friends. Good to see you again. I wanted to read you another story. And since the first official day of spring was on Friday, today is Sunday, I thought we'd read a story about a garden because spring is coming and it's time to start planting our gardens and watch everything grow. So this book is called The Curious Garden. This is a little boy named Liam, and you'll see what happens with him in this story. The Curious Garden. There once was a city without any gardens or trees or anything. Most people spent their time inside. As you can imagine, it was a very dreary, boring place. However, there was one boy who loved being outside. Even on rainy days, when everybody else stayed inside, you could always find Liam happily splashing through his neighborhood. And it was on one such morning that Liam made several surprising discoveries. He was wandering around the old railway, as he did from time to time, when he stumbled upon a dark stairwell. And here he is, right down here, and here's the stairwell leading up to the tracks. The railway had stopped working ages ago, and since Liam had always wanted to explore the tracks, there was only one thing left for this curious boy to do. What do you think he's gonna do? Liam ran up the stairs, pushed open the door, and stepped out onto the railway. And the first thing he saw was a lonely patch of color. Wildflowers and plants were the last thing he expected to find there. But when he took a closer look, it became clear that the plants were starting to die. They needed a gardener. Who do you think the gardener will be? Think about that. Liam may not have been a gardener, but he knew that he could help. So he returned to the railway the very next day and he got to work. The flowers nearly drowned and he had a few pruning problems, but the plants patiently waited while Liam found better ways to garden. And as the weeks rolled by, Liam began to feel like a real gardener and the plants began to feel like a real garden. And if you see, they're starting to grow. Most gardens stay in one place, but this was no ordinary garden. With miles of open roadway ahead, the garden was growing restless, and it too wanted to explore. The tough little weeds and the mosses were the first to move. They popped up farther and farther down the tracks and were followed by the more delicate plants. And over the next few months, Liam and the curious garden explored every corner of the old railway. And you can see the garden starting to spread all through the old tracks. And there it is. And there's Liam. And here it goes through the tracks. After spending spring, summer, and fall with his garden, Liam's time on the railway was finally interrupted by the winter, and heavy blankets of snow fell on the city that season. And for the first time since he'd become a gardener, Liam could not visit his plants. They're covered in snow. So rather than waste his winter worrying about his garden, he spent his time getting ready for spring. And after 3 cold months, the snow finally began to melt, and Liam rolled his new gardening gear over to the railway. Winter had taken a toll on his garden. Uh-oh. Looks like things are starting to die. But thanks to Liam's planning, his handy new tools, and a little help from the sun, the plants soon woke up from their winter sleep. And they're back. The garden had always wanted to explore the rest of the city, and that spring it was finally ready to make a move. Once again, the tough little weeds and the mosses set out first. They popped up farther and farther from the railway and were closely followed by the more delicate plants. The garden was especially curious about old forgotten things. So here's some plants growing in an old abandoned car, and there's plants growing in the cracks and out of windows. A few plants popped up where they did not belong, like on this stop sign or on this fire hydrant. Others mysteriously popped up all at once. But the most surprising things that popped up were all of the new gardeners. Look at all the kids wanting to come and help Liam. They're all over this big smiling garden. And it looks like a lot of people are enjoying the city garden all over the city. Many, many years later, the entire city blossomed and bloomed. But all of the new gardeners, Liam's favorite, was where it all began. And there's this little tree from the very beginning of the story. And by the end, it became a big, beautiful tree. And that's the story of The Curious Garden by Peter Brown. So I hope you enjoyed this story. I have want to show you one. Oh wait, here's a final photo. There's the whole city that used to be all dark and brown. Now it's green and growing. So I have one thing to show you. I am going to email moms and dads a spring scavenger hunt for you to do at home. This is an outside activity. If we were at school together, we would put this on a clipboard and take a bag, and we would go out to the yard and try to find all of these things, collect them in your bag, a leaf, a bug, a stick, a rock, a yellow dandelion, or any kind of flower that you may see, and a clover. And see if you can collect all of these things. I will send this sheet home. And I have one more thing I want to show you. We are building a garden at our house. So Mr. Savetta is out back working on it. Let's go see him. Ready?
I'll take it.
Thank you, Will.
Here we go. We're going to go out the back door, and let's see if we can see our garden. Here it is. There's our new garden. There's Mr. Savetta out there. Well, looks like he's not working. He's chatting. Maisie's mom's gonna be very proud of me. And here's the beds that all the plants are going to go in. We're still building it. It's not finished yet, but I was hoping that you guys can send me some suggestions about what we can plant in our new garden. So let me know what you think. Let me know what you want us to grow, and we'll grow it. All right. Miss you guys. Hope to see you soon. Okay. Bye.